Former Senator and former Armed Forces Chief Rodolfo Biazon has passed away. He was 88 and had been diagnosed with lung cancer in July last year. His son, Muntinlupa City Mayor Rufy Biazon, said his father died at around 8:30 this morning after battling pneumonia. The younger Biazon also called it fitting that his father passed away today, Independence Day.
He did everything really with all sincerity for the country, for the people. Kung gaano siya kasimple nung bata siya, the way I've known him, hanggang when he was a nobody. Just a regular he was a regular soldier hanggang ngayon nas naging senator, congressman, AFP chief of staff, ordinary citizen Biazon. He remained the simple man that he was.
Biazon's friends and colleagues at the Armed Forces of the Philippines mourned his passing. Retired Lieutenant General Ernesto Carolina remembers Biazon as a legislator who cared deeply for veterans' welfare.
He was still, enthusiastic General Biazon, sharing his 10 cents worth about major issues, especially the South China Sea. General Biazon was really a very supportive legislator. Many of the major legislations that promoted the welfare and well-being of veterans were authored by or co-authored in the Senate by former Senator Biazon. He really did a lot for our veterans. And he is one of one of the veterans that we are really proud of.
Philippine senators mourning the death of Biazon. For Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri, Biazon's passing makes this year's Independence Day bittersweet. He then remembered Biazon as one of the country's staunchest defenders of peace and democracy. Senator Risa Ontiveros, meanwhile, thanked Biazon for always answering the call of duty, even when he was no longer in office. For Senator Grace Poe, the Philippines lost an exemplar soldier and lawmaker, adding Biazon's work in fortifying the military will not be forgotten. Meanwhile, the Defense Department pays tribute to the former AFP chief, whom it described as someone who embodied patriotism, integrity, and commitment to the protection of the country's freedom.